Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We continue our live coverage of a special day in the history of the state of Kuwait, a day where 12 martyrs lost their lives in a battle that has become known as the Al-Qurain Martyrs battle, or in a house in Al-Qurain area where a group of 19 Kuwaiti youth decided to take it upon themselves to combat and help liberate their countries from the Iraqi occupation. With me here in the studio is my colleague Sarah Glob. Sarah, we're waiting for news on the play that reenacts the events that took place on that fateful day.
Yeah, hopefully it should be starting anytime soon. I think they're pretty much set to go, as we can see on the screen that's coming to us live from the actual location. So they've set up the lights and everything. It's going to be interesting to see this play. I think it's the first time as well that they've introduced the story in the form of a theatrical performance. Mm-hmm. So I think it should be very interesting to watch. And as we know, art speaks all languages, you know, so it will be it will be there for people who don't speak Arabic, who speak English, even for children, for adults. They will all understand the deep history and sentiment behind this huge battle that was, as you mentioned, fought by 12 members of that resistance group, that they took it upon their own hands to defend their country, and they did everything they can, basically, to defend their country. And they succeeded in the end, so they came out victorious. And although some of them did sacrifice their lives, there were seven among them who survived. And this museum is a tribute. It's dedicated to those 12 martyrs. And if you walk around inside the museum, you'll see each, there are plaques and the pictures of the martyrs in the same spots and the locations where they died. So it's actually as if you're walking through that point in history. Mm-hmm. So they've done a really good job at trying to, you know, bring about the same sort of...
They've kept the destruction of the house.
Yes.
Most of, you know, if you were to go there and visit this place, you'll actually be... feel the horror of the day, you know. Imagine being one of those 19 people hiding inside the house while tanks are shelling one shell after the other, machine gun fire, machine guns of all sizes and types being used against you while you're hiding and seeing the walls, your protection falling apart minute by minute.
It's in ruins, you know.
For 10 hours.
Yeah, in the heart of Mubarak al-Kibriya, one of the biggest cities in Kuwait. It's in the heart of that city. And if you go on any other day, the place is just, it's in ruins. It's a battleground scene.
I saw pictures. They have a fence surrounding the area, the three houses.
Yeah, I've been there, actually. But not today. Today, it actually looks like...
a new place.
Yeah, it does. It actually looks
very
intriguing.
Lots of lighting.
They've lit it up. There's flags adorned all over the building. There's balloons. The people around it, they've caused such a crowd around the place that it just seems like it's such a festive atmosphere. And I wish I was there among them and with Sadam there on the
scene. Well, it's sad and festive at the same time. It's sad because people lost their lives, but it's festive and happy because Kuwait gained its liberation, gained its freedom. And as Shahab mentioned earlier in the interview, that Kuwait is proud of its democracy and of the future of democracy. And this is what we truly believe in as people, as nationals of this country, that democracy should always prevail.
Well, I mean, you're celebrating the 25th and the 26th, not just Kuwait's liberation, you're celebrating its independence, which is the birth of its constitution, the establishment of its independence. So it's just the whole, you know, existence of Kuwait wouldn't be what it is today without these 2 days. So
the
celebrations you thought started about a month ago, I think they're just starting today. Mm-hmm. And you can see that now everybody's out there. people express their patriotism in so many different forms. You see people, they're wearing accessories that depict the colors of the Kuwaiti flag. Mm-hmm. Some of them actually wear dresses that are the colors the of flags, the flag.
Yeah.
Everybody's out in their national dress. It's just a very special occasion for Kuwaitis.
If Salem Al-Kandari is listening to us, or if our producer can relay the message to him, it would be nice to talk to the producer of the play.
Yeah,
the director
some of
the play, and to see what went into actually organizing this play. And
I'd also like to know his vision, you know, because every director, every artist has their own forms of expression, and they always try to add that little touch. So I'd like to see his perception, how he intends to, you know.
It'd be good to listen to him, to listen to what he has to say.
He probably has some very nice insight on the matter, particularly since, you know, organizing such a play like that would take some research, it would take a lot of things. So he must have come across some very useful information. And it was up to him to decide whether to disregard it or whether to emphasize it in the play. Mm-hmm. So we'd like to know, you know, his methods and his insight towards the whole idea. It will be a fresh perspective.
And it's like taking us back to 23 years ago when the actual event took place. I'm hoping that we'll be able to have the camera take a close up, and so that we can actually listen and watch what is taking place over there.
Yeah, I think we will be transmitting it live. I think even the KTV1 will be transmitting it live. So hopefully we'll be able to see not of all of it, at least the majority of it. And also it would be nice for, you know, because the families and the children of the martyrs are also there celebrating with the people. It's a big day for them too. And it would also be interesting to see how they thought of the play and what they think of the atmosphere. We spoke to some of them earlier, and it's nice to see that, you know, every year they do turn up and participate, and you know, the names of their relatives will live on, you know, not just through this house and through the building, but in so many different forms.
You said that you had been to this location previously.
I've been. I went, yeah.
You visited the... there are three houses.
Yes.
Were you able to visit all the three houses?
No, or just I didn't visit all the three. Unfortunately, it was very brief.
On a report, maybe.
No, I was actually... I was in the studio. It was the same event, but about a few years ago. And after it had finished, I was so hyped up about the whole thing that I said I had to go down. Mm. But by the time I got there, most of the festivities were finished and they were over. And most of the crowds had gone too. But at least I got to see it, and I satisfied my... my.
Do you encourage everybody to go out there and
I do.
Experience the place?
I do. I mean, I believe, you know, if you're living in a country, then you should experience what you can of that country.
Well, we have so many other
there's so many things here in Kuwait.
Places to visit.
There's definitely so many. But this one is a little gem just tucked away. Nobody knows about it, you know, especially if you're talking about foreigners or expatriates. If you don't know the history or the details about, you know, the Iraqi invasion and the occupation and the later liberation, then you wouldn't know that this was one of the big battlegrounds. And you wouldn't even be able to find the house, you know, because really it's tucked away deep within. You have to go through the roads and the areas. And it is definitely, there's a few locations in Kuwait like that. But I do think, you know, if you come across something, then it's important to say that at least I've been down, I've seen it, you know.
Yeah, I have to admit that I haven't had the chance to go there, but I will, just like you, know, now today that I'm covering, or we're speaking about this this museum, I will definitely go out there.
Kuwait is such a small country, so as soon as you find out that there's something that you haven't seen, you know.
I have been to the Bait al-Kuwait lil-A'mal al-Wataniya, which is the Kuwait House for National
Works.
Have you been there?
That's near the societies and.
That's right. It's on the way to heading to the new Kuwait Oil Company location. There, it's also an interesting place where they've designed a house with all kinds of artifacts from the war, and including weapons, including some of the there were also some reenactments of done in like a just where they put like toys to depict what was going on, you know, cars and soldiers as toys, and then you have a lighting show. It was very interesting. I had the chance to do a report then. It was for CNN, if I remember. This was quite a few years ago.
See, it's interesting because that is another one location that not many people know about and is really tucked away. I actually stumbled across that on my way because it's near the Human Rights Society Environmental Society. So I was on my way there and I stumbled across it and just thought, hey, what is this place? I've never even heard of it before. Mm-hmm. Even when you, in school, you take school trips, they take you to the Kuwait National Museum, they take you to the planetarium, things like that. But I've never even heard of that place until I stumbled across it. So there are these spots in Kuwait that are very secluded and not really publicized.
They need to be more publicized.
I definitely believe so.
And it's our job to do that as well. I mean, such as what we are doing today.
For this, Even there's the Mubarak kiosk in the heart of Mubarakiyeh. And people didn't even know it existed up until a few years ago. I think it was inaugurated in 2010. And before that, nobody even knew what it was, but it was the first legislative office in Kuwait, you know? So when you dig deep and you find these places and you find out their history, a lot of them have a lot of significance.
Well, it's you. You're a correspondent, Sarah, as well as a news announcer.
Hopefully we'll try to
along
do
along with
something.
The other colleagues, yes, we should do more homework and dig in. And try to find out more about these locations so that our viewers, our the
well
expat population gets this valuable information. Maybe to them they might want to go out there and visit
well,
these places.
Well, you hear all the time people say, oh, there's no museums in Kuwait, or oh, there's no, you know, such and such. But this is the thing, there are a lot, you know. It's just they're not publicized, you know, or people are not aware of them as much.
Yes, we have, as we can see from the live feed that we're getting on in the right box on your television monitor, we see people preparing, lights flickering back and forth, but we are still awaiting news of when the play is going to start to begin.
They're still located at the premises of the Qurain Martyrs Museum, and the play is set to take place
very soon. Salim Al-Kandari is there, and we're waiting for some news from him. But until we get some news, let's listen to some more national songs. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to our live coverage of this memorable day, commemorizing the martyrs of the Al-Qurain House. Of course, today was we will be seeing very soon, maybe if the producer is hearing anything from Mr. Salim Al-Kandari, our correspondent, back at the location of the museum. We are waiting for the announcement of the play to take place, a play which is going to reenact what took place 23 years ago today, when a group of Kuwaiti youth decided to take on the Iraqi army to help do what they can to help liberate their nation from the Iraqi occupation. Again, on the monitor to your right, on the monitor we have the live feed from the Al-Qurain Museum, where the play is about to begin. Okay, now there's the recital with verses from the Holy Quran.
بتيجي يعني نفسهم من السيارة أسوي أنا ماني مصدق يصير هذا كله في الكويت
هنا الكويت أيها المواطنون الكويتيون الأحرار أيها العرب في كل مكان صورة مخزية للغدر نفسه إن غزو الكويت باسم العروبة هو أحد أعاجيب الدنيا ولكن متى عرف الطغيان الحياء إن نشيد العروبة على فمهم كان خدعة إن حماية العروبة في إعلانهم كان مكرا ومناورة تحدثوا عن القيم وخانوها وتحدثوا عن الخيانة وتمرغوا في حمأتها وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون
الرحيم هنا الكويت أيها العرب أيها الأخوة الأشقاء أيها الأخوة الأحبة أيها المسلمون أخوانكم في الكويت أخوانكم في الكويت ينادونكم فسارعوا لنجدتها
جئتكم برسالة شعب كانت أرضه بالأمس القريب منارة للتعايش السلمي والأخاء بين الأمم وكانت داره ملتقى الشعوب الآمنة التي لا تنشد سوى العيش الكريم والبناء والعمل وها هو اليوم بين شريد هائم يحتضن الأمل في مأواه وبين سجين ومناضل يرفض بدمه وروحه أن يستسلم ويستكين للاحتلال مهما بلغ عنفوانه وبطشه
كبير خلاي حقونه عشان الصوره اللي معلقه صوره جابر اللي يسواه جوره سعد حطموا شباب نطقوهم طق علشان الصوره كثر ما ادور كثر ما عفسوا بالبيت وباقوا وكنا ما يخالف بس الصور خشيناهم مثل ما خشيناها بطنه بقلبنا همنا في قلبنا الظالم اللي ما خاف من ربه
يا الله بذلك وين هذا البيت بيت كل أهل الكويت، بيت آبائنا وأجدادنا اللي ضحوا لأجل بلادنا. إحنا فقدنا آبائنا لكن عزانا وجودكم يمنا يلي شلتوا همنا.
أهل بلدنا يا عزنا وذخرنا، أنتوا في هالدنيا سندنا.
ما أحس إني يتيمة وأنا بين هالقلوب الرحيمة.
احنا عيالكم وما غبنا عن بالكم،
ما غبنا عن بالكم.
الرايه ما طاحت من ايد ابونا الشهيد، الرايه بنرفعها ونعليها فوق من ايدي.
شلتونا وسط العيون، خليتوا الحزن فينا يهون.
ان عهدك يا وطن عهد، نصون الوعد ونتكاتف كلنا ونبني البلد،
ونبني البلد.
ما نبي هالذكرى تكون النهاية، نبي من هالبيت تكون البداية.
بنعطي هالوطن حب وخلاص بليا ثمن.
بابا صباح،
بابا صباح في ظلك ربينا، وتبقى يا أميرنا غالي علينا،
غالي علينا.
Wait, hold on!
شهداء الكويت، شهداء هذا الوطن في كل وقت. اي والله، اي والله، وكل زمن شهداء الكويت. تبقون، تبقون انتم في الذاكرة يلي سقيتوا هذه الأرض من دماءكم الطاهرة، ونبت فيها العز والفخر على مدى الدهر، يلي سقيتوا هذه الأرض من دماءكم الطاهرة، ونبت فيها العز والفخر على مدى الدهر. سميناكم عشاق الوطن، نعم انتو عشاق الوطن، تركتوا لنا بصمة لا يمكن ننساها. بصمتك يا شهيد في قلوبنا شلناها، بصمتك انت وانت وانت يا شهداء الكويت في القلب احنا شلناها. رسمتوا، رسمتوا لنا لوحة حب ولونتوها بدم القلب، لوحة فيها تضحيات وعبر، لوحة فيها شموخ وفخر. يا حكاية من بدت يا ناس ترى ما انتهت، اكتبوها في صفحة الخلود أروع قصة هي في الوجود، قصة نرددها جيل ورا جيل، قصة هذا الشعب الأصيل. يا شهيد، يا شهيد، يا شهيد، يا شهيد، دمك ما يضيع يا تاج انت على راس الجميع. الوطن كله من شرقه لغربه يعني لكم حبه، الوطن كله من شرقه لغربه يعلن لكم حبه، وفيكم احنا نفتخر ترى طول العمر، واللي قدم روحه فدى الوطن يبقى حي. اي والله يبقى حي في قلوبنا طول الزمن، يبقى حي في قلوبنا طول الزمن. شهداء الكويت، شهداء هذا الوطن في كل وقت وفي كل زمن، وفي كل زمن.
بيتك يا بيت القرين، وبخاطري ذكرى تحمل ألم وجروح، أبي أحاورك يمكن من بعد ما أسمعك تهدى فيني النفس والروح. أبي أسألك سؤال يمكن يهدى البال،
سألي سألي يا بنت البطل، يلي أبوك كان قول وفعل، كتب على جبين الزمن قصة اسمها عشق الوطن.
أبي أسألك شو اللي صار، وليش هالنار، وليش هالدمار، وليش السقف انهدم، وليش جدرانك تلطخ دم.
كان في هالبيت وقت المعركة 17 بطل، ارفعوا راية العزة والأمل، قاوموا العدو الغاشم الخاين الظالم. 5 أبطال نجوا و12 استشهدوا. ضحوا برواحهم، ما فكروا بمال وولد، همهم بس عزة هالبلد، وتعاهدوا الكويت ما يمسها حاقد، وهذا دمهم على وعدهم شاهد. قصة قصة ترويها أجيال وأجيال عن عزيمة شهدائنا الأبطال.
أبيك يا بيت تقول وتوصف حالهم، أبي الدنيا كلها تعرف عن أفعالهم.
كانوا جماعة باسم المسيلة ابتدوا، وباسم عشق الوطن استشهدوا.
يا بيت خبرني عن أبوي الحنون، اللي لجل بلاد الروح عنده تهون. خبرني خبرني عن آخر لحظة في حياته، عن شموخة وعزته وذاته.
أبوك أبوك كان قائد مجموعة الأسود، طلب رفع علم الكويت بوجه الطغاة والحشود. ما استسلم أبد، قاوم مقاومة عنيفة لين صافحت جسمه قذيفة واستشهد.
بس 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 يا بيت يكفي، نار نار الحزن فيني ما تطفي. أتذكر وأبكي إني فقدته، لكن عند رب احتسبته، خلاني خلاني مكسورة الجناح بين دمع وألم وجراح.
لا يا بنتي، انسي الألم انسي الحزن، وتذكري ان شهيد الوطن لك الفخر كل الفخر. أبوك غير كل البشر، أبوك حي عند رب الرحيم في جنة ونعيم.
نعم يا بيت، نعم يا بيت، أنا شفت فيك معنى البطولة، معنى الفداء. شفت علم بلادي مرسوم بدم الشهداء،
وحسيت بحب وإخلاص. شهدائنا البواسل ما هزهم صوت الرصاص ولا هزتهم القنابل. سمعت صوت الدبابة تدوي تقرب من البيت وبدت بقذايفها ترمي. وحسيت بزلزال يهز الأرض والسقف يتطاير. وسمعت أصوات تنادي عاشت بلادي عاش الوطن عاش الأمير. آه يا عشق الوطن آه يا العشق الكبير. وبدأ الاقتحام ورفضوا شهدائنا الاستسلام. وشف دم عامر فرج معنزي أول شهيد كان لابس علم الكويت وتلون العلم بدمه لكن ما همه. وسمعت ثاني شهيد سيد هادي العلوي يقول رفعوا العلم مع كل قذيفة. كان يسأل عساكم بخير ويناديهم بالاسم. وعلى سطح هذا البيت صابته دبابة صابته قذيفة هشمت فيه الراس يا ناس وقطعت فيه كف الإيد. وشفت ثالث شهيد يوسف خبير أول من رفع علم الكويت كان يقول الكويت هي الأول وهي التالي. كان يقول بنحررك يا بلد لا تحزنين أبد يا نموت بكرامة أو نعيش بكرامة. وهذا كان آخر كلام. سمع جاسم محمد علي يقول أتمنى أشوف أولادي لكن بلاده كانت أعز من أولاده ورب رزقته وأمين من بعد يوم من استشهاده. ومبارك سفر كان يرميهم من البيت الثاني بيشغلهم ويشتتهم يبي عن المجموعة يبعدهم. وعبد الله مندني اللي قاوم بشجاعة ما هم النزيف اللي شل ذراعه. حب الكويت نساه الألم حب الكويت يجري بعروقه مع الدم. خالد الكندري رجل المقاومة كان يقول حب الكويت ما فيها مساومة. كان يهتف باسم الكويت وينادي تهون الروح ولا أشوف دمعة من عيونك يا بلادي. وحسين علي رضا يصرخ هالغزو ونرفضه وبنقاوم وبنكتب دمنا رسالة للعالم إن الكويت من عمرها حرة وإن الكويت من عمرها درة. وإحنا شبابها بنحمي ترابها. ومحمد عثمان الشايع الطلقة كانت الفكة وربط فكة بشماغة وعن بلاده قاوم ودافع. وبدر العيدان صاحب هالبيت اللي قدم روحه هدية للكويت كان تحت التعذيب. احرقوه يا عالم بنار ولهيب. ما هم النار والجمر كان يقول يا كويت فداك العمر. وخليل خير الله البلوشي اللي قدم للوطن أروع صورة ما هز الخوف إحساسه وشعوره. كانت بعيونه نظرة تحدي وعزة نفس. كان يقول الكويت هي غلا عمري وبس. اي والله هي غلا عمره وبس. وابراهيم سفر كان آخر شهيد كنت أسمع صوته من بعيد يقول لأجل بلادي يهون الموت. لين سكت هالصوت.
في هالمكان سال دم الشهيد كتب للزمان قصة شعب علي. في هالمكان سال دم الشهيد كتب للزمان قصة شعب علي. ما بدل الغدر بالخفا في دهننا يوم النصر حاومنا كلنا
بطل. اي والله 12 بطل 12 رجل 12 شجاع نعم كان وسباع 12 اسم محفورين في القلب والوجدان 12 اسم اهم معنى التضحية والحب وكلمني يا بيت عن اللي نجوا شاركوا بالمعركة وما استسلموا
كان في البيت وقت المعركة 17 مقاوم من مجموعة المسيلة استشهدوا 3 في البيت و9 خذوهم أسرى واعدموهم واحد واحد اعدموهم بدم بارد واللي نجوا من المعركة 5 أبطال محمد يوسف كريم سامي سيد هادي جمال البناي طلال سلطان الهزاع حازم جابر صالح كل يبي يفدي بروح بلاده لكن ربك ما كتب لهم الشهادة وكانوا شهود على اللي صار على الموت والدمار وقالوا لنا قصة كل شهيد وشلون تصافحوا ايد بايد
وسألت ابوي شلون هان عليك العمر وهان عليك ولدك اللي كان لك القلب والنظر شالك بدينا يا يبا من بير رصاص الغدر ووسدك الأرض ورد علي صوت أبوي الشهيد ورد علي يا عالم صوت أبوي الشهيد أنا أرخصت الروح يا يبا للي أغلى من الروح، لأني عاشق هالأرض وغلاها ما يمحي طول الزمن. هذه الكويت، هذه الكويت، وآه آه يا عشق الوطن.
وفي هالمكان سال دم الشهيد، كتب للزمان قصة شعب عنيد.
عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق نبتدي منه اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه. عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق نبتدي منه اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه. شهد الكويت، نعم نعم كفيت ووفيت، نعم نعم يا شهد الكويت، نعم نعم كفيت ووفيت. بالتضحية انت البطل تبقى لنا الله مثل، بالتضحية انت البطل تبقى لنا الله مثل. نعم نعم يا شهد الكويت، نعم نعم كفيت ووفيت، نعم نعم يا شهيد الكويت، نعم نعم كفيت ووفيت. بالتضحية انت البطل تبقى لنا الله مثل، بالتضحية انت البطل وتبقى لنا الله مثل. من اجلنا رخصت والروح فدا، في ليلنا نور الوطن فيكم بدا. من أجلنا رخصت والروح فدا، في ليلنا نور الوطن فيكم بدا. تراب الوطن اللي حضنكم بكل فخر يحكي لنا دوم عنكم. تراب الوطن اللي حضنكم بكل فخر يحكي لنا دوم عنكم. عشق نبتدي منه اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه. عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق الوطن اللي كتبه دم الشهيد، طول الزمن في قلوبنا غلا يزيد. عشق نبتدي منه اسأل الزمن عنه، اسأل الزمن عنه.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Well, as we just saw, we first started with a documentary that led up to the play that we just watched, coming from the Al-Qurain Martyrs Museum. What did you think of the play, Sarah? Nicely organized, well done. Lots of time, I'm sure, took them a long time, a lot of time to.
It did, because there was a lot of choreography involved, and I mean, from the lyrics to the dancing to the costumes and everything. I mean, that just takes quite some preparation. And the play had everything, you know. It had an intriguing mm-hmm. beginning. It had the climactic middle, and it had the big bang at the end. So, mm-hmm. I mean, there's nothing more that you can ask for.
Well, as we come close to the end of our live coverage of the commemorations that are taking place at the Al-Qurain Martyrs Museum, and as we approach news time, the English news team will be coming on very soon with the 7 o'clock news.
Mm. I think it's important to thank everybody, first of all, involved
yes,
in the preparation of this day. Definitely big thanks to the Ministry of Information and the Ministry of Interior for keeping the roads and everything safe for
the
everybody.
The Martyrs Bureau.
The Martyrs Bureau, the National Council for Cultural Arts and Letters, as well as our correspondent on the scene, Salam Al-Kandiri. A big thank you.
A wonderful job today.
A big thank you to you. Mm-hmm. Without you, I don't think we could have had such a great coverage from mm-hmm. location.
With live interviews yeah. throughout the evening.
Yeah. Very good effort from him. And also, just to remind everybody as well that we will be on tomorrow and the day after, on the 25th and the 26th.
That's right.
From the morning, from 9 a.m. in the morning until mm-hmm. 6:30 till 7 p.m. in the evening. And we're going to be covering all the events that are happening throughout the country celebrating
right.
the National and the Liberation Day.
On and location and on the in the studio.
Yeah, we're going to be coming from the Kuwait Towers. There's a mm-hmm. celebration there. Anybody who cannot make it down there to join in the celebrations will be here
Turn
in the studio.
The
yeah, giving you all of the feedback of everything that's happening. And there will be some really great interviews. We'll see a lot of great mm-hmm. programs that have been prepared
for the occasion.
Yeah, the Absolutely. Staff here has been working really hard in the run-up to this for these 2 days, so expect a lot of great viewing airtime tomorrow.
Well, thank you, Sarah, for co-hosting this program, this live program with me this evening.
Yeah, thank you, and thank you. He's prepared all the information that we read out today, so thank you for that. Without
thank you,
that
My
wouldn't
pleasure.
Have been able to, we wouldn't have been able to give people all this deep detail of the event.
Well, we look forward to receiving more details from you. You will be on the program tomorrow, I believe.
I'll be on Wednesday.
You're on Wednesday.
Yeah,
Adib Shaber will be here.
Yeah, Adib as well as Tariq Al-Aryan. And then in
Badriya.
The afternoon, there's Badriya Al-Saleh. She's our newcomer. Mm-hmm. And Ahmad Maki. And then in the evening period, we have Farid Dashti.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think Ahmad Maki is also yeah. going to stay on till evening.
This pretty much and makes then, up the whole team.
Yeah, on Wednesday, the only difference addition is myself and Lulwa Al-Ghaith, who will
Excellent.
Also be here
Super.
In the evening.
Well, wish you all the best of luck on those two very important days for the state of Kuwait. And as we come to the conclusion, I would like to wish all Kuwaiti nationals, especially our leadership, as well as all Kuwaiti people, a very happy National and Liberation Days. Thank you for watching and have a very good night.
وطني الكويت سلمت للمجد وعلى جبينك طالع السعد وطني الكويت سلمت للمجد وعلى جبينك طالع السعد وطني الكويت